anything wrong and naughty, Johnny would be doing it, you know. Oh, he'd jump into the horse trough, he'd try and empty it, he'd do anything.
Oral history, of course, takes many forms. It's been handed down verbally from generation to generation for thousands of years. These days, there are very many very experienced amateur oral historians and, of course, the professionals. And there are journalists come documentary makers. I've been a journalist in various forms since the late 1960s, and a particular love over the years has been to get people talking about their lives, and often in out-of-the-way places. Now, I know I look about 12 in this photo, but I was actually 23, and I was on my second trip around outback Australia as a freelance radio documentary maker for the ABC. Going bush was a great way to meet, well, yes, flies, but also a collection of unique characters. I wandered outback sheep stations, prospecting camps, silver and gold mines, railway settlements, Aboriginal encampments, and top-end communities. Some of these old-timers would be around 135 years old if they were still alive today.
You know what that is? I wish it was a fish with a great long tail. I wish it was a fish with a great long tail. What a tiny little winkleback or a smackalore away in the bottom of the deep blue. That's hard to play, you know. You've got to get the you can't get enough wind. You've got to, you know, when you're going, it's going in too much the one way. I wish it was a fish with a great long tail.
My first trip on the road, my father was 9 years old. We took cattle from a place called Idamere. They call it Glen Ormison now. We went right into Swan Hill and Victoria. I think we ended up to about 16 weeks on the road. We used to have wagonettes and pack horses.
You said that you started driving when you were 9 years old. What did you do for school?
Well, most of the school I had, my sister taught me, one of my sisters. That's why I never had much of a chance, because I'd get home, I might have, anything up to 6 weeks, 7 weeks with her. Then I'd go on another droving trip, but what she taught me I'd forget. Mm. But I've been gifted to two things, as I thank for that. That's counting cattle or making up an account. I lift me out to no man at counting a mob of bullocks out in the flat.
Voice alone is such a powerful medium. It fires up our emotions and paints such vivid scenes in our mind's eye. Personally, though, these days, I like to add the video element.
People in Stratford and that, anyone that she knew was in need, would get a basket of goodies, wouldn't they?
Yes.
She was marvellous to us. Like, you go up there and she'd make a meal out of nearly nothing if you couldn't, because things were really, when they're really tough, you're always bloody hungry.
And see, they were self-producing. Like, we used to churn the cream to make the butter in this little wooden churn. You'd go like this, and then the butter would form, and then you'd get the paddles and pat it into the
squares.
Oblongs or squares. Yeah.
So there you go. A little bit about one kind of oral historian. It's highly satisfying and a great privilege to be able to chronicle the lives of others.